Hi, I'm David Duncan, and I'm an experience consultant at InterWorks. Keep your sizing and spacing consistent to help your dashboard feel unified. Whitespace has a major function in making your dashboard feel connected and stable. And when spacing is off, whether it be between line items or filters or icons, it starts to feel like Tableau is controlling your experience instead of you controlling that Tableau experience. I like to group things if there are many of one thing, whether it be a filter or a list of names or items, group all of those things in one area and then base that design off of that group of all of those things together. There's no need to fill up blank space on a dashboard by adding another chart because breathing room is sometimes good for us. It helps the user feel like they're not overwhelmed or missing out on something if they don't read every single thing on the screen. Now that Tableau allows people to use transparent sheets to show their data, one thing I unfortunately see too much of is people using that to showcase a photo behind their data. My theory is that photos should be shown in all their glory, while data needs a lot of clarity and understanding, so those two things don't mix very well. So I'm going to talk about a couple things you can do to use images strategically to help lay out your content. At InterWorks, we use transparent sheets in order to help us align our dashboards and organize large amounts of content. We'll place a placeholder template PNG behind all of our data in a dashboard, arrange the content, then delete that template PNG once everything is organized. So sometimes we take things a step further and go into a tool like Adobe XD or Sketch to create custom graphics to help organize all of this content. And these small touches really do help elevate people's data by breaking some of those Tableau conventions and letting the real content shine and not necessarily the photo. The most common chart that I see on a dashboard is the bar chart. So I'm going to give you a couple tips to help make these bar charts a little bit more exciting and not the normal boring that you might consider them to be. So first, consider the bar width. Make sure that the bar isn't too heavy compared to the line item or a numerical value next to it. We don't want the chart to feel lopsided or like it's going to tip over. Use color to grab attention. I normally keep the bar charts fairly low contrast because a lot of times they're just reporting some numerical values, but then we can add in color to start bringing in highlights or showing an alert for something. Also, left align all of the text in that list. So if you have a long list of things in this bar chart, it'll just really help your users scan that list quickly and find what they're looking for. Check out the comment section. There's a great resource called the Bar Chart Menu. It's by Robert Rouse, and you can download the Tableau workbook to use these bar charts as your own template.